Thinking about getting a tattoo? Yes. On momentaryink.com, you can have your tattoo idea turned into a temporary tattoo, so you can try it out before you get it on your body forever. That's actually a great idea. I love temporary tattoos as a 5-year-old. If I would get them, I would feel like such a tough guy. You know, the gangster on the corner that no one wants to mess with. In math class, I'm just like, yeah, check me out. But really, no one liked me. But I'm thinking about getting my actual, like, first real tattoo soon. Like, probably right here, just because. And now I want to get a big one on my back. And then, you know, a nice face tattoo all over. It's gonna be great. But before we get to that, what's up, guys? No, I'm not gonna get a face tattoo, but why not? Anyways, yes, we're checking out some life hacks that you cannot live without. You will thank me later. But before we get to it, please subscribe and follow me on Instagram. Links are all down below, and please like and share the video. And comment below what your first tattoo would be, and let's go. Try applying your deodorant at night instead of in the morning. It'll be more effective and you'll sweat less the next day. Well, I don't know about that, just because most of the good deodorants that work, they have aluminum in them, and that's really bad for you. I've tried all the non-aluminum deodorants and it is a lost cause. They're terrible. So I don't know if you want to be putting this stuff on like 24/7. Like when you're sleeping, there's no need for it. You don't need to put that stuff in your body. Shoes a little too small? Yes, that has happened to me. It sucks. Fill a Ziploc bag with water and place it in your shoes. Then put them in the freezer overnight. They will expand half a shoe size. Dude, I need to try that. I bought my boyfriend some shoes for Christmas, but they came in the wrong size. And it's only by half a size. I should try this. I'll let you know if it works on Instagram. On stuffyoucanafford.com, you can buy super cool gifts and gadgets for almost no money. I actually tried the link, and it just takes you to this website that shows you all of the Amazon products that are $20 and under. And some of them are cool. Most of them are useless, but hey, if you need something for Christmas last minute, get one of those. Want to know if someone has romantic feelings for you? Yes, all the time. Look at their eyes. People's pupils expand by 45% when looking at a love interest. Okay, I don't know about that. I mean, I don't know if I pay that much attention to their pupils, but I know they will look you in the eyes more often if they're actually interested in the conversation you're having. But if they're looking around like somewhere else or their feet are pointing away from you, then that means they're trying to find an excuse to get away. When you get a call from a telemarketer, don't say anything and press 9 on your phone. This will automatically add your number to their don't call list. I will try that. I hate when I get those random calls about my car's extended warranty and crap and a free cruise to the Bahamas. Yeah, that'd be nice, but it's not true. So I will try pressing 9 next time. If you're ever attacked by a brown bear, play dead. If it's a black bear, punch it in the nose and it will run away. Bruh, I don't know if you can get close enough without getting mauled. If you get attacked by a bear, pray to anything. If you don't believe in anything, then just pray to the bunny that's like watching you get eaten alive. Be like, bruh, help me. I need somebody. Or try talking to him. But dude, if it was that bear that ate like over 100 tons of cocaine and he died like an hour later, if you ran into that guy, I'm sorry, you're dead. You're dead twice. When your dog gets out, don't chase it. Lie down and pretend you're hurt. They'll come back to see if you're okay. I don't know about that. I've seen that challenge on TikTok a million times, and half the time, the dog doesn't care. He's just like, okay, bye, where's my food? He doesn't care about you. But yeah, you shouldn't chase your dog just because they think it's a game and they're gonna keep running. So get like a treat or something, they'll come back. Buying something from Apple? Always. Add it to your shopping cart and don't buy it yet. In 7 to 10 days, they'll give you a 15 to 20% discount on that item. If that's true, I've been wasting so much money. Oh my God. Someone try this, comment below if it works. I need an Apple Watch. Photo hack. Tilting your head to the right and slightly up makes you look more attractive. Really? Like this? Like this? Is that working? How's my neck? But just tilting it to the right makes you look more intelligent. Do I look smarter, guys? Huh? Like this? Do I look real smart? No. But I do always tilt my face in any selfie. I'm just like, So the double chin goes away. Sticking your fingers in your ears for a few seconds can instantly get rid of hiccups. No, it doesn't. It just makes you look dumb. You're sitting there in the middle of a restaurant like, and then you start doing this. That doesn't work. You just look dumb. Most people know that using your space bar scrolls down a web page. Sometimes. You can change the settings. But if you hold the shift key and hit the space bar, it'll scroll back up. Okay. Or you could just use the mouse like a normal person. Not sure if you're in a bad neighborhood? Nope. Look at store windows. Plate glass means you're in a good one. Plate glass with bars means you should leave before dark. When the street lights turn on, you need to get home. And if you see plywood, leave immediately. Like, get out of there. Those people are worried constantly about being robbed. If you swear at Apple's automated customer service, it puts you through to a human. I wish I have tried that with other companies and it never works. So don't go cussing at Apple's customer service machine, because then your mom's gonna tell you to unsubscribe to me because I'm a bad influence. But let me know if it works. To exit a maze in a game or in real life, touch your hand to the right wall and keep walking like that. You'll eventually reach the exit. But what if it's over there? To the left! I don't know if this would work. That doesn't sound very... Like, I'm pretty good at mazes. They're not that hard. So this one sounds kind of dumb. With the promo code 9INNY, you can get any pizza you want at Pizza Hut for $9. I mean, I don't like Pizza Hut. I'm a Domino's girl. They're way better in my opinion. But try it. Let me know if you get a free pizza. And I don't even have $9. Buy your plane tickets during the middle of the week to save $100 or more. Ticket vendors jack up the prices on the weekend to trap vacationers who make impulse buys. That is true, and you should try to buy your plane tickets as far in advance before your flight as you can. Cause the closer it gets to that actual date, they jack up the prices. So try to buy your tickets like 3 months in advance on a Wednesday. If your phone freezes, plug it into a charger. This will free it up again. Really? I've been restarting my phone this whole time like a dummy? Beach hack. Buy a diaper and insert your valuables. Roll it up so it looks used. Boom. Never have anything stolen at the beach again. I mean, I've never had anything stolen at the beach because usually we're pretty spaced out, especially with social distancing now. But that's a good idea. Hide your stuff in something that no one would ever want to touch. Get a brown Sharpie and, you know, just add a little like poop streak to it. Extra protection. When doing sit-ups, if you place your tongue on the roof of your mouth, it will stop your neck from straining. I hate that. I mean, I don't do sit-ups anymore. I only did them in PE when they made me for the stupid physical test. But yeah, I always had that problem. That's why I always tried to support my neck and they told me that was cheating. I was like, no, my neck freaking hurts. But if you're doing sit-ups when no one's forcing you to and you just do it for fun, you're crazy. Need to tell a believable lie? Yeah, always. Include an embarrassing detail. Nobody doubts a story that makes you look dumb. Well, all of my stories make me look dumb because I don't know how to tell a good story. I always get off track. Seriously, I always have like 5 different plot lines going on the side and then like backstories to all the main characters. And they're like, wait, what were you even talking about? I don't know. I can't just get straight to the point. But anyways, that is it for life hacks that you cannot live without. And now you don't have to, because you know, you're welcome. As always, please subscribe, follow me on Instagram, links are all down below, and please like and share the video. And comment below your own life hack you think we should know, and I will see you weird people next time.